I guess you consider me getting into my senior years. I've been a contractor. I am a contractor. I'm a parent of two wonderful daughters, and I have a wonderful son-in-law, and I'm transgender. You never really want to be transgender. It's something you live with. When I decided I needed to do this, about 10 years ago. There's the ugly duckling stage. No matter what you do, you dress up, in female clothes, and you go out with a purse over your shoulder, and you get called sir. And that doesn't happen anymore, thank heavens. I didn't know what the word was back then. And actually, it was my wife who brought it up to the girls that we were getting separated, and the reason why, because I dressed up in women's clothing, and they couldn't believe that she was leaving because of that reason. Of course, it goes a lot deeper than that, but that was basically the easiest way to explain it to the girls. And so she's the one who really had the fortitude to come out to the family that way. I couldn't. It was quite an embarrassment. But my wife, I mean, she basically lived with us, with me, for the pretty well the whole length of our marriage. Well, this kind of dabbled in and out of our relationship. People are different, and whether it's natural selection or whatever you would call it, but people are different, both in the gender identity, gender expression, whether gay, lesbian. When this sort of was creeping into my brain, somewhere just prior to puberty, which from all the research I've done and the people I've talked to, that might actually be a little bit late. Usually, people know around age 3 or 4 years old that their identity is somehow different than what they were born with. But for me, I believe it was prior to puberty at some point. So for whatever reason, I don't know. I mean, just that these issues started creeping up. It's a tough journey. It's you got three choices to make when you go on this journey, or before you go on this journey. Do you want to continue to live in mental misery? Do you want to do a transition, which is to change your gender to whatever stage? Not all of us change gender right to the full scope of it. Or you commit suicide because you just can't live with it anymore. And I chose, probably in my mind, the easiest thing to do was to do a transition. Now, some people would say easy. Well, two things, the other two things are pretty devastating. So yeah, this was the easiest part of those three choices. A teenager, 15 years old, that comes out to their parent, and the parent just can't do it, deal with it. Next thing you know, that child is homeless, because that's that child's choice. I've got to live what I need to live. And to do it, you got to leave home, okay? Or as an adult, do you lose your job? Do you lose your family? I was fortunate I didn't lose my job, but I wasn't fortunate enough that I didn't lose some of my family. Saying that, my wife stayed my best friend. We had a very good relationship. We just couldn't stay married. It's a tough journey, and it's not one that should be taken lightly. My happiness is my children. Period. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be here. Being true to yourself, being honest to yourself. And because this is life-changing for you, life-changing for your family, for your friends, your coworkers. And sometimes that life-changing is not great. I've been fortunate.